Hey, this is Paul from Wondershare Mobile Trans, and if you're a fan of Huawei, what you'll have seen is in the past couple of weeks that they have announced HarmonyOS 2 alongside their Watch 3, their MatePad Pro 2, and a couple of really other exciting announcements. And what we'll do today is have a look at the future of HarmonyOS, because this is actually something that is really exciting whether you're a Huawei fan or not. They've got a lot of stuff in the pipeline. Apparently they've got new wearables, they've got new tech, they've got new software, they've got potentially even VR glasses that are on the way. So let's get into that video. Huawei have now officially announced HarmonyOS 2, and what Huawei want to do is try and create an ecosystem, a little bit like Apple have done with their products and their software. Huawei have come up with this really catchy tagline as well, which is one as all as one. Which makes you think now that with the devices that they're going to release and with HarmonyOS 2, that switching between devices, taking tasks from a phone to a pad to a laptop, is going to be a lot easier and a lot simpler than it ever has been, and just make it a little bit more fun for the user. Okay, let's have a bit of a rundown and a bit of a history of what's happening with Huawei and HarmonyOS. So, back in 2012, the company started working on an unknown operating system. But as you know, in 2019, Huawei were banned from using the Google Play services, which meant that if you wanted to go and download a new app, you couldn't do that through the Google Play Store. And because of this, Huawei had to start working on its own operating system in 2019 because Google didn't really leave them a choice, which then meant, of course, that's when HarmonyOS appeared. And now, just 2 years later, we get to see the brand new version of this, which is known as HarmonyOS 2. And the really interesting thing, we said this earlier in the video, that HarmonyOS 2 is not just something designed to work on mobile devices, but designed to work on lots of different devices across a network, almost creating an ecosystem like we have with Apple. This means that HarmonyOS will work on different smart devices, so things like wearables, like, for example, a watch, your phone, your laptop, your tablet, and potentially even vehicles. There's rumors that HarmonyOS might even work in cars. HarmonyOS first made its debut in Honor TVs. That's the first time we ever saw it. And of course, Honor is owned by Huawei, so it made sense to put it into a product like that first. But now you can see it on things like the Huawei Watch 3, their tablets, and even the Mate 40. This, of course, now means if you buy a new Huawei phone, it will come pre-installed with HarmonyOS 2. And it even means that older Huawei devices can upgrade to that HarmonyOS 2, so you're not missing out on some of those new features that will be in the software. One of the reasons why we want to create this ecosystem is to help out the developers. It'll mean that they can save time when designing apps and overall just make it a little bit easier for everyone, which in turn means it makes it easier for the user and that user experience. So if you get a Huawei phone and you're in that ecosystem already, you then see that Huawei released a speaker and you think, right, I'll go and get a Huawei speaker. And then you think, right, I've got a phone, I've got a speaker, well, let's go get a Huawei watch, and then you know that it's going to seamlessly work on all of your devices and make it a lot easier than having lots of different devices owned by different companies and be in different ecosystems. Ben Wood at CSS Insights said that HarmonyOS is designed to provide the glue, and that Huawei will be hoping it can follow in Apple's lead by having a single software platform that just extends in all directions. And that's something that we mentioned earlier on in the video. One of the big things facing the IoT ecosystem is that there are so many IoT-enabled products, and these get managed by various different applications. It was mentioned that HarmonyOS is here to provide a unified language between products, just to make it easier for the user, the buyer, the developers, everyone. Huawei compared this new HarmonyOS to something quite strange, but did compare it to people. They mentioned that people communicate through a unified language so that they think that their software and their hardware should do exactly the same, and that is what they hope to use HarmonyOS 2 for. In short, HarmonyOS provides a single device for all situations, and that means that smart devices will collaborate together and take Huawei and HarmonyOS from an isolated ecosystem into something that is much more involved. One of the most interesting things that have come from Huawei is that they want to let you use one single device to control everything, which is going to be called a super device, which to me I think sounds really cool. This means that if your super device is using HarmonyOS, it can control every other device that is also using HarmonyOS. And let me explain how this one kind of works. If you have a phone and tablet linked and are on HarmonyOS, it will look for one of your devices and name it as that super device, which then means you can take tasks from one phone over to the other using the task center. And this just makes it a lot easier and a little bit like Apple with notes, for example. So if you write a note on your phone, you can go to your Mac and then you can carry on writing that note. And you can even control what applications run where. Then you look at something like the wearables, like the Huawei Watch 3, and then you think, how does HarmonyOS work with this? Well, for this, what you'll be able to do with this is take a photo on your phone, but from your watch, so you don't even have to go and touch your phone. Then the watch can do other things as well on that HarmonyOS. It can store your travel passes and your boarding passes. You can then check the score of your favorite sports team, or you can even then start controlling the lights in your smart home if it's all linked with HarmonyOS 2, which means that the watch will have a control panel implementation. If you think, though, Huawei are done there with what we've mentioned, then you would be very wrong, because at the moment, Huawei are in the middle of a timeline. This started, of course, in 2019 with those Honor TVs that we mentioned earlier on, and last year, Huawei announced their watches and other wearables. But in the next couple of years leading up to 2022, we expect to see things like HarmonyOS 4 in that time. We should see some smart speakers, headphones, and even potentially some VR glasses from Huawei. And with Huawei at the moment, it sounds like a really exciting time to be part of this Huawei ecosystem, or that the ecosystem that they're trying to create, enhance, and make better. And remember, we could end up having these super devices which can control everything from our homes to our watches to our speakers, all from one device. And one of the main highlights from Huawei is that HarmonyOS is going to be unleashed as an open source platform, so it gives people that chance to create, innovate, and make things that they might not have been able to do before. When it comes to the HarmonyOS ecosystem, Huawei will share its core capabilities and open up regarding the concepts like camera, AI, and connectivity. And furthermore to that, to assure and provide customers with an excellent experience in terms of service and app delivery. And that means that Huawei will move and work closely with other organizations to make this ecosystem the best it could be. And it's a really exciting time for Huawei, and it might be the end of this video, but for Huawei, it is just the beginning. But if you enjoyed this video, why not give it a like, subscribe to the channel as well, and if you do all of that, we will see you in the next video.